Is cotton sustainable? What about viscose? Is polyester really that bad? If you're someone who buys fabric to sew their own clothes, or even someone who just wants to shop for clothes without ruining the environment, this video is for you. Buckle up, because there is a lot of misinformation out there. And yes, I am on one of these goddamn electric scooters. Myth number one, cotton, linen, and other natural fibers are sustainable, and synthetics like polyester are not. So it's not that this is completely wrong. I mean, polyester is pretty unsustainable, and we're going to talk about why that is in a second. And cotton and linen certainly can be grown and turned into fabric sustainably, but can't assume that that's always going to be the case. So in order to debunk this myth, let's talk about what sustainability actually means. For the purposes of this video, I'm going to define sustainable to mean fibers or fabrics that have a relatively small impact on the environment compared to more conventional fabrics or fibers that have a significant negative environmental impact. The tricky thing here is that environmental impact can refer to a lot of things. For example, you have greenhouse gas emissions, which is the pollution that causes climate change. And obviously polyester is one of the more famous villains in this category because it is typically made out of petroleum, which needs to be extracted from the ground, which requires a lot of energy and often releases greenhouse gases into the atmosphere as it's being extracted. But natural fibers can also contribute to climate pollution. A lot of agricultural machinery and inputs that would be used to cultivate cotton or linen also release greenhouse gases. So even though it might be less than polyester, which I imagine that it is, it's still contributing to climate change potentially. You also have water use and water pollution. Cotton can be a thirsty owl, as some of you may know. Now, my understanding is that you can grow cotton without obscene amounts of water. However, conventional cotton growing practices are extremely water intensive. And dyeing and finishing fabrics, no matter what fiber it's made of, is odious. Like, you know it's bad when I use a word like odious. Honestly, though, truly disgusting. A lot of these chemicals are extremely hazardous to the environment and human health, and often, if not properly regulated, they are just disposed of into the water or the air, which is just awful. And finally, you have biodiversity loss and habitat destruction, which is something that can be caused by natural or synthetic fibers, because extracting petroleum from the ground often disturbs surrounding ecosystems, while farming cotton in a non-sustainable way can deplete the soil of nutrients, kill native pollinators, and contribute to habitat loss for animals. So even though cotton has the potential to be a lot better than polyester under certain conditions, and linen even more so, there is a lot of potential for very bad things lurking under the surface of each of the stages of production. And that's not even including transportation and distribution to customers and end-of-life disposal, which we're going to talk a bit about towards the end of the video.
So the reason I was on those blasted e-scooters is because I was making a trip to the fabric store. That leads me to
myth number two, bamboo is just so sustainable and natural. So first of all, folks, this one may knock your socks off. Bamboo is actually not classified as a natural fabric. I know, I was so shocked when I learned this. Bamboo, when used for fabric to make clothing or whatever, is a semi-synthetic fiber. Semi-synthetic fibers have a natural origin, in this case, the bamboo plant itself, and then they undergo a chemical transformation in a lab to alter the molecular structure in order to make it more suitable for fabric production. Fabrics that are made this way, whether they're made from bamboo or some other type of plant, are called rayon. I do want to quickly note that there is a form of bamboo sometimes used for clothing that is classified as a natural fiber, and it is sometimes called bamboo linen because it is made essentially in the same way that linen is made from flax. However, it is pretty uncommon, and if you have clothing that's just labeled bamboo, most likely what it is rayon. So is semi-synthetic bamboo rayon or bamboo viscose, and I'm going to talk about what viscose is in a second, sustainable? Again, similar to natural fibers, you should not assume that it is. Bamboo does have some major sustainability advantages compared to other fibers. It is considered a renewable resource because of how quickly it can regenerate after it is cut down. It requires less water, fertilizer, and pesticides to grow than many crops. And it can grow on marginal land, so my understanding is that you wouldn't have to clear-cut a biodiverse forest or displace other agricultural or food production in order to grow it. That said, just because you can grow bamboo sustainably doesn't mean that everybody does. Forests in general that are being used for commercial purposes need to be sustainably managed in order to not have negative impacts on the surrounding ecosystems. But they're not always managed that way. Furthermore, the chemical process required to turn bamboo into rayon uses many harsh chemicals, that can have really devastating impacts on the environment and human health, and are not always safely disposed of. This brings me to talking about viscose, lyocell, and modal. These are all subtypes of rayon. They're all made from plant fibers, typically wood pulp, that undergo a chemical process. Lyocell is a specific process, I believe, making it distinct from viscose and modal. Tencel is a brand name of lyocell owned by Lenzing, which is an Austrian company. I'm not exactly clear on what the distinction is between viscose and modal. There is a lot of conflicting information online, so I'm not going to try to delve into it. However, what you need to know is basically these are all subtypes of rayon. So are they sustainable? Again, the devil is in the details. Are the forests that the wood pulp comes from sustainably managed? Or even better, are the fibers made from recycled cellulose or agricultural waste byproducts? This is something that we're going to see more of, I think. Cotton from old clothes or plant fibers from agricultural waste that can be turned into various types of rayon. As for the chemicals used to turn these plant fibers into their new molecular form, is the manufacturer taking care to make sure that these chemicals are recaptured and disposed of safely? Or better yet, is the manufacturer using a closed-loop system where not only are these chemicals recaptured, they are then reused? If the viscose or lyocell or modal or whatever is made from cellulosic fibers from sustainably managed forests, or better yet, from recycled or waste fibers, and if it's made in a closed-loop system where the chemicals are captured and reused, then yes, that is going to be a sustainable fabric, most likely. But the majority of rayon fabrics are not made in these kind of systems, therefore, you really need evidence and proof in order to be certain that you're buying something sustainable. Lenzing, which I mentioned before, is a good bet on this front. There are also the Okotex Made in Green and STEP standards, which certify that fabrics were made under sustainable conditions, and my understanding is that these are pretty rigorous certifications. Third-party certifications are always best when it comes to evaluating whether or not a product is sustainable, because brands will sometimes write sneaky things to mislead you into thinking that their products are sustainable when really they are not. This is referred to as greenwashing. I'm not saying that all brands are lying or exaggerating their sustainability claims, but they may well be, so it's important to do your research and evaluate their claims before buying. All right, third and final myth, I can just throw clothing made out of natural fibers into the garbage because it's organic, so it will just decompose in a landfill. Speaking of landfills, I trekked out to my local landfill on my bike. For this video, I didn't end up seeing much because the actual huge pit where they put all the garbage is in a big hill that is not really visible for the road, and I was not allowed to, you know, trespass and go in. However, I'm still glad I went, and I think it is a good idea, if you can, to go see where garbage in your region actually goes. So back to the myth, will your natural fiber clothing just decompose in a landfill? No. This is a misconception that people have about food scraps as well. I often have conversations with people where they're like, so why do I have to put like my food scraps into the compost? Landfill is just a big hole with dirt in it. How is that any different than a compost heap? Very different. Things do not decompose in a landfill in the same way that they would at an industrial composting facility or your backyard compost heap. In a landfill, organic material, whether that's food scraps or natural fibers like a cotton t-shirt, are buried under very densely packed layers of other waste. They are not exposed to light or oxygen, so they cannot decompose the way they would outside a landfill. When organic matter decomposes without oxygen or without sufficient oxygen, it releases methane into the atmosphere, which is a powerful greenhouse gas that contributes to global warming. In fact, in many North American cities, waste is one of the top contributors to greenhouse gases because organic matter is sitting in the landfill emitting terrible gas into the atmosphere. Now, polyester, on the other hand, seems to leak less methane into the atmosphere when it's in the landfill because it is inorganic. So maybe it's less bad to have synthetic-based clothing or fabric in a landfill than natural fibers, although really, clothing and fabric should ideally not be in the landfill in the first place. So you might be wondering, well, what should I do with used clothing then? So if your item of clothing is in good condition and you think would be of value to somebody, you can always try to resell or donate it. You can always learn to mend your clothing as well, and I'd highly recommend doing that. You know, like replacing a button or an elastic that is shot, or using thread to mend little holes. If it's not in good condition, like it has big stains or holes that cannot be easily repaired, you can see if your city has a textile recycling program where fabric scraps are clothing in poor condition is accepted. Often these marginal textiles will be shredded for things like insulation. Unfortunately, not every city has such a program. In fact, I think it's quite rare. Textile recycling really is in its infancy, and I hope that that changes soon. In the meantime, if you can't find anything to do with your marginal textiles and it's in too poor condition to sell or donate, you probably just should throw it out. It pains me to say that because I really don't think that fabric should be in a landfill. There are other things that could be done with it. The infrastructure right now just does not exist in a lot of places to be able to capture, sort, and effectively recycle textiles. But ultimately, I think it's better if these textiles go to our own landfills in our own cities instead of having poor quality textiles get donated, not have anyone want them because they're poor quality, and then have them exported to the global south where they might potentially end up on a beach or in a desert. In terms of composting, because I have heard people ask me before, well, can I just put, like, you know, my cotton t-shirt in the compost? I would not recommend putting your clothing or other fabric scraps into your city's compost bin unless you've checked like your city or region's website and they explicitly say that they will accept textiles in their composting program. I think that is pretty uncommon though. I doubt most places do because industrial composting facilities just typically are not set up to accept textiles. And furthermore, there are sometimes dyes or finishes that could taint the finished compost that, you know, waste management professionals don't want in there. Now, if you have a backyard compost heap, you could try cutting up your natural fiber clothing or fabrics only into little scraps, mixing them with food scraps and putting them in the compost. You definitely want to remove the thread, just cut out around it because that's typically made of polyester that can go in the garbage. As well as any trims like elastics or buttons, things like that, which would not be compostable. You could try it. Again, similar to industrial composting, there might be dyes or finishes that could be harmful to the compost that you don't really want getting into the soil or the water. So approach this with caution. If you're really comfortable and you know where you got your fabrics from, you're confident that it was, you know, unbleached, undyed, doesn't have finishes on it, or it has a certification saying that, you know, it was not made with harmful chemicals, then it's probably safe to put your natural or even semi-synthetic fibers, because they're plant-based, they will degrade too, into your backyard compost heap. You could try it. So be careful out there, folks. There is greenwashing absolutely everywhere. Thanks so much for watching and see you in the next video.